Students, let's continue with the financial intermediaries. In the previous class, we have studied jobbers and brokers, who are the main players and who are the authorized members of stock exchange to trade with all types of securities. Just to brush up, broker, who is a authorized member, works for the commission and is not a specialist, okay, because you can call him as an intermediary between company and investors. Whereas jobber, who quotes two prices to the broker, that is one for buying and one for selling, and who can be called as specialist in case of buying and selling of securities. He is not an agent and who is an independent dealer of stock exchange, and his profit is fixed by competition among themselves as a dealers. So continuing further, Tarwani Wallahs are found in Bombay Stock Exchange especially, and they are called brokers and Tarwani Wallahs. There are two types, so one already we have studied. All this is done unofficially. So the Tarwani Wallahs act both as jobbers as well as brokers, because already you know the meaning of jobbers as well as broker. Students, broker act as a middleman between company and the investor. Jobber acts as an independent dealer who buy and sell shares on behalf of himself, okay, or else he can give this assignment to the brokers. See, he is doing both. He quotes two prices to the broker, that is one for buying and another one is for selling. So I think you can remember this point, that is Tarwani Wallahs, with this point, that is they act or they combine both the functions of jobbers and brokers. In other words, they often performs the task of both a broker and dealer in securities. They may act on behalf of non-member investors or in their own name. So both combining jobbers and brokers, you can call them it as Tarwani Wallahs. Hope this is clear. So what do you mean by this? Odd lot, the name itself is suggesting, lies. It is odd man out. So what, how, in what sense it is odd? So these traders, These traders are trade orders made by the investors that include less than 100 shares. So I think in the example you will get to know very clearly, students. If there are 75 shares, it would be an odd lot. For example, there are altogether 500 shares, and they have, so whatever demand they have got is only for 420 shares, for example. Then how much is remaining? So 500 was their expectation, then 420 shares they have opted. So then how can they do this? So ultimately it will be a bunch of 100 shares to make it a round figure. Then obviously the remaining 80 shares they have to make in one bunch, that you can call it as odd lot. Hope this is clear. So 75 shares would be an odd lot since it is below 100 shares, while 300 shares would be counted as a round lot. Why is it? Because you can make a bunch of 100 very neatly. So since it can be evenly divided by 100, while round lots are posted on the associated exchange, odd lots are not posted as part of the bid or ask data. Then who are purchasing the shares? So these shares will be given to those people or individual investors. That's what it is mentioned here, individual investors, because the theory believes that they are less educated and influential in the market overall. So it can be allotted to the individual investors. Okay, so that is what is called as odd lot dealers. So round lot means it can be evenly round figured with 100, as well as the leftover will be called as odd lot. Those cannot be a multiple of 100. Hope you got it. So in simple terms, students, remisers, they are the sub brokers appointed by the brokers to create business for them. You can remisers or also can be remembered as commission agents. To increase the business of the brokers, these brokers are appointing the remisers who can work, who can create more business for them, for which they have been paid monthly salary by the brokers. Okay, because these remisers are not allowed to trade on the floor of stock exchange because they are not the direct dealers. Rather, they are the agents of these brokers who wants to get more business for their business or else the stock exchange operations. I hope this is very clear. There are jobbers, there are brokers, and again brokers who is acting as an independent, who is acting as a dealer between the company and the investor, will be having remisers for what? To increase his own business. Clear? In simple terms, for which he will be paid a fixed monthly salary because he is a, you can call him as a commission agent, or else you can a simple agent, or else a worker who is working for the brokers. So they are the sub brokers appointed by the brokers to create more business for them. So I think since you have a MCQ type of questions, I think all these type of dealers you have to go through very carefully. The meaning with the explanation, even the main heading can be asked, or else vice versa. So remisers, I hope it is clear, students. It means the stock exchange authorizes their brokers to appoint employees to carry on the business on their behalf. Clear, students? So remisers were the sub brokers appointed by the broker itself, whereas authorized clerks are appointed by whom? They are appointed by the broker itself, but who has given that authority? The stock exchange itself has given, authorizes their brokers to appoint the employees to carry on the business on their behalf. Please don't get confused, students. Remisers are appointed by the brokers itself, but they are not the authorized persons or else who can act on behalf of brokers. So he can only get the, they are just like a sales executive, what you can say. Okay, so how sales executives are working for the company to get more business, so similarly they are working for the brokers. But here these authorized clerks can do those things which are done by the brokers. They are acting on behalf of their brokers. So they have been paid salary plus commission up to 50% on the business done by them. If they have brought business worth ₹1,000, on which 50% will go to this authorized clerks. So plus salary is fixed for them because they are the employees of their brokers. Okay, because they have given the authority by the stock exchange itself to deal on behalf of their brokers. I hope these two points are very clear. So then it comes the speculators, which is important. Okay, so I think all these concepts in this chapter are very much favorite for and very much suitable also for your MCQ type of question. So what do you mean by speculation, students? Is not a new term. Speculation is the buying of an asset or financial instrument with the hope that price of the asset or financial instrument will increase in the future. Speculative investors tend to make decisions more often based on technical analysis of market price action rather than on the fundamental analysis of an asset or security. They are also tend to be more active market traders, often seeking to profit from short-term price fluctuations as opposed to being buy and hold investors. So don't be scared with the long definition or long explanation here. So how can you? Speculation is all about estimation of the future rise or fall in the prices. Both are possible, students. Speculation is a guesswork. So all this with all this speculation of increase and rise in prices of the shares, derivatives or any other asset or securities, and at the same time you can also expect a fall in the prices of these securities or shares or debentures or any other derivatives. That is called as financial instruments. So with this guesswork, all the speculators who are working in the stock exchange will contribute to the overall tendency of stock market. You know, just a simple example, student, if the demand for any one type of goods, or else if you take a education institution itself, so how can you say that one is good or else one is best college among the cities? It is only because of sometimes the criterias will change, like based on the rankings, based on the admissions, based on the quality, and based on the output batch, what they are telling about the quality of the teachers as well as the college. So all this speculation, and it goes word by the word of mouth spreads so fastly that either the positive or either the negative or either the mediocre image you will have about the institution or about the company which you have to choose, right? So accordingly you will make a decision. So similarly here, some of the speculators, they're expecting that the Infosys company's price may shoot up because the CEO is a versatile leader in the industry. So this is an assumption. They have not yet announced the CEO has been changed. But with this versatile leader, even the speculation, you know, the positive speculation will go up, and accordingly the share prices of Infosys also may shoot up. Just a speculation of increase in the dividend by 10% in the next financial year may again increase the share prices also. There is a resignation among some of the board of directors or the board of directors, or else from the company there is a withdrawal of shares. Again, it's a gossip, but still it will have an impact, students, on the share prices of the respective company. So whatever moves they are taking will have an impact on the prices of the respective company shares. So this is what is called as speculation, guesswork. And that is a reason why we call stock market as a gambling. Clear? Because everything depends upon your analysis. Again, it is not that we are talking about the mantras. It is all about the technical analysis of the market price. Okay, each reason, what is the reason which is making or the contributing for the share prices to shoot up or fall down. So this technical analysis has to be done by the speculators accurately, so then only their speculation goes in their direction. So let's see, okay, who are those speculators? Famously, a great entrepreneur of Microsoft and the founder of Apple company, Steve Jobs, were speculators. And even you might have heard about the Warren Buffett, who is the richest investor in the world, is a speculator again. And even they were venture capitalists also. The people who fund startups for new ideas and new business are called as speculators. In short, speculators are an important and valuable part of the world's financial markets because they create fortunes, nourish ideas, business and economies, and who help to create the next big thing. Okay, because based on their speculation, the mass behavior may change with reference to the company's selection of shares as well as the prospectus of the company. So let's move. So the first speculator in the stock market is bull or Tejewala. So you might be surprised why. I think in PUC already we have studied the regarding the stock exchange in detail, where you might have heard why this description of the animals is given to the stock brokers or else the speculators of the stock market. Just look at this picture carefully, students. So this is an aggressive bull. Okay, So where, how the aggressive bull will attack their opponents with their horns, you know, like they'll shoot up. So in the same manner, even this bull speculator will always expect future rise in prices of securities. He buys the securities without taking delivery to sell them at a future date. That means they are only in his account, okay, and he is not keeping it for longer period. But why he has taken? Because now when he has purchased the shares, the share price will be low. Okay, so purchase at lower price and sell it at higher price is the simple strategy of this bull speculator. So who buys the holding in the stock with the expectation that in very short term it will rise in the value, whereupon they will sell the stock to make quick profit on the transaction. So here, so he will not have taken even a delivery of this stock. For example, consider 2009 and 10 bull market, 2009 to 20 year bull market, which was the longest in stock market. Okay, so after flooding as a result of 2008 financial crisis, the Standard and Poor, that is a rating companies S&P, the 500 bottomed out in March 2009 and then proceeded to climb until early 2020, and when the COVID-19 pandemic sent the stocks crashing. So 2008 was witnessing year for financial crisis, where all the banks, the major banks of India as well as the foreign banks, were in financial crunches, wherein they were unable to collect the debts back. Okay, and even the deregulation of the government was one of the reason for this financial crisis. So since then, the 500 bottom out companies were out of the market. And not only that, since then there was a climb in the stock market strategy until early 20th, before the pandemic which was rapidly hit the stock market. So till then, after COVID pandemic, the stock market has crashed. So until then there was a climb. That means from 2009 to 2020, the market tendency was bull market, wherein there was expectation, there was more investment in the stock market itself. Then you may ask, like, in which are the other avenues where you can invest? As I told you, there are risk-free returns, there are mutual funds, students. Okay, even there are various type of other investments, even in gold investments you can invest. Okay, so all these investment, out of all these investment avenues, if the investor is choosing, more investors are choosing the bull, that is stock market itself, obviously the prices of the securities may rise. So that is a tendency of bull market. Everywhere there is an expectation of rise in the prices. The next one is bear or mandi walas. So bear is a speculator who expects the prices of securities to fall in future. Okay, so the opposite of the bull speculator who expect rise in the prices, and bear speculator who expect the fall in the prices. And with that anticipation, a bearish speculator sells short securities aiming to earn profit from being able to repurchase them at a lower price at some point of time in the future. For example, the share price is 100 now. Okay. Now what he will do? He will try to sell, but his expectation is in future date the share price may fall to 80. So what will be his reaction now? The bear speculator, now he want to sell immediately at 100 rupees, and in very future date he wants to purchase the same securities for rupees 80. So that means He can earn rupees 20 as a profit with the same transaction. Now the share price is 100 and immediately he will sell off. And on the future date, when the share prices come down, okay, because that is what his expectation. And if his expectation will be fulfilled and the market also supports his expectation, then he is a successful bear speculator whose expectation of fall in prices did occur, and accordingly he also earned profit of rupees how much? That is rupees 20. I hope this is clear, students. It's very simple as it is. You know, the common strategies which we apply in our day-to-day life also. So this is bull speculator who is very optimist and the price is going up. Okay, you can just remember this picture and you can think about the features also. And the bear speculator is a pessimistic who is expecting the prices to go down. So bear speculator is also a speculator who sells various securities for the objective of taking advantage of an expected fall in the prices. So he is always in a position to impose of security which he does not possess. In this way, he makes the profit on each transaction. And he may suffer losses also, students, please make it a point. He may suffer losses also if the prices of security rises by the date of delivery. So that is what is the risk of stock exchange which each one of us have to accept. So if the prices fall down as per his expectation, then he earns profit. If not, surely he is going to suffer losses, because in the previous example, the share prices when he sold was 80, and to his surprise, the share prices shoot up with rupees 150. Then how can he purchase, right? So that is a loss for him. So that is what is the danger in the stock market always. So moving ahead, the next speculator in the stock market is called as stag. So stag speculator who applies for securities of new company with the idea of selling them at a premium after allotment. His profit is the excess of the price at which he sells his allotment over the amount paid by him while applying. So he expects that the prices of securities that he applies for would increase. So please note a point. It is almost near to your bull speculator, whatever we have studied, the first case. You know, bull and stag will be almost similar, and bear and lame duck will be similar. So stag speculator who operates in the new market, he applies for large number of shares in the new issue by paying application and allotment money. Okay. So only for new companies he is dealing with, the securities of new company he is dealing with. What is the strategy? So that selling them at a premium after allotment. So he will purchase the company shares for a lower prices, but with the expectation of what? So he can sell it at a premium rate. That means more than what he has purchased after the allotment. So his profit is the excess of price at which he sells his allotment over the amount paid by him while applying. That is nothing but, students, it is purchase price minus selling price. That's it. He is purchased at rupees 180 and he has sold the same share price as at rupees 100. Then how much is the profit? That is selling price minus purchase price is equal to 20. That's what the slide says about. Hope this is clear. Then the next one is lame duck. Lame duck is a bear speculator who has agreed to sell certain securities on a particular date. Okay, who has agreed to sell certain securities on a particular date at specific price, but finds it difficult to supply the securities on the settlement date. That's what it is, almost nearer to bear speculator, I told. So again, Lemberg is a bear speculator who has agreed to sell certain securities on a particular date at a specific price. But now he is finding very difficult to settle at the same date and as for the same price also. For example, he might have assured to sell the securities at rupees 80 in future. You know, I'm just taking the same example so that it will be convincing for you. He has sold the securities with the expectation of price fall. Okay, his expectation was rupees 80, for example. But unfortunately, he has sold at rupees 100. Okay, this is the selling price. And what is he expecting? Rupees 80. The share prices may fall so that he can purchase the same securities for 80 rupees. So 20 rupees will be the profit, right? But to his surprise, if it went up to rupees 120, then can he incur a loss? Absolutely, he incurs loss. So that's what the sentence says. They find it difficult to supply the securities on the settlement date for the agreed price of rupees 80. Clear, students? So he's struggling like a lame duck in the river, you know. Even though it looks very calm as well as peaceful from the outside. So beneath the river, the legs, it is moving so fast as well as it is very much struggling to survive in the river. So very much fastly the legs will be moving. So this is what is the description of that lame duck, bull or bear. No? With the features of these animals only, you can remember what is the meaning of lame duck, bull or bear. So lame duck who are struggling to settle the prices as per their expectation. I hope the things is clear. So now, so far we have studied the major players of stock exchange, jobbers, brokers, then odd lot dealers, remisers, authorized clerks, speculators. In that we have studied bull, bear, stag and lame duck. Okay, students. So in the next class we'll be studying with the importance of stock exchange as well as dealers in stock exchange. Thank you.